My name is Lara, and I'm here to talk to you about those pesky parasites we all know and love, fleas. Fleas are a common problem in San Diego County, and because it does not typically freeze here, you can see them all year round. But in the summertime is when we see the most outbreaks because the environmental factors are absolutely perfect for flea breeding. Fleas are found worldwide, and there are different species of them. The most common species here is the Tenocephalides felis, or the cat flea. Though it is called a cat flea, it can also be found on dogs. A flea's life cycle is approximately 3 to 4 months. They start the cycle as an egg, and then morph into a larval stage, and then onto a pupae stage, and finally become an adult flea. The egg, pupae, and larval stage are very small and extremely hard to see with the naked eye. The most common sign that your cat has fleas is the gritty, dirt-like substance of flea feces, or the fleas themselves. Fleas are hematophagic, which means they eat blood. So when you see those little black specks on your cat and you get them wet, they will turn a blood red color. Those specks are what we call flea dirt or flea feces, which is the digested blood from your cat. As you know, cats are great groomers, and because of this, sometimes when they're grooming, they may ingest a flea. Fleas are the intermediate host for tapeworms and can cause a tapeworm infestation in your cat. The good news is that tapeworms are one of the few internal parasites that you can see in feces with the naked eye. A tapeworm is a long, flat, and segmented worm. It is hermaphroditic, which means it can reproduce alone. This ribbon-like worm is divided into segments called proglottids. And these are the pieces that exit through the cat's anus during defecation. These are often identified as grains of rice, or if dried and found on the fur, they look like sesame seeds. Fortunately, tapeworms are really easy to treat, but it is important that you get the flea infestation under control, because all it takes is one flea and then your cat has tapeworms again. If you suspect fleas at all, the best way to tell is to brush your cat with a flea comb, just like this one. If you find one flea or even some flea dirt, it's time to start treating your cat. Fleas have been known to hop a ride on our shoes, socks, and even our pant legs. So even if your cat is indoor only, it is important to check for fleas on a regular basis. Though you can be bit by a flea, humans are not the preferred host of fleas, and if there is a cat or dog around, they would much rather be on them. Having said that, fleas can cause disease in humans, such as cat scratch disease, tapeworms, and even a local reaction to an area where they bit you, such as inflammation or itching at the site. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions at all, please let us know. We'll be more than happy to help.